We're talking thousands, we're talking thousands of pounds, we also know, but we're not deliberately, we're not giving them back. But just one penny, my dear Islam brothers, if that is the punishment, then imagine those people whose hobby it is to rob someone. It is our hobby to go and steal someone's money. Now, it might be a hobby, or it might be that we are engaged in something else, and we have to do that. For example, one of the Islamic brothers, we were on a Madani Kafila. We met a Buzurg of 70 years old. He sat around us in a study circle whilst we were learning the Sunnah of the Prophet, and he says, and he started crying. And one of the brothers, he went up to them and he says, Babaji, what are you crying for? And he goes, by looking at you, I feel so proud. And I know that your parents would be so proud of you. I've got one son as well. He's a drug addict. And he goes, every day, my son, he needs £300 to fulfill his drug habit. Tell me, where am I going to get £300 from? Now, someone who needs £300 for his drug addiction, what is he going to do? He's not going to have overtime because he's not even going to work. Why? Because he's so addicted to that. Now, that person, he will either end up killing someone and robbing that person, or he will end up doing something else and might kill himself as well. My dear Islam brothers, a poor person. Today, alhamdulillah, Allah Ta'ala has given us so much. We call ourselves, alhamdulillah, we are rich. Even though we say we don't have anything, we are rich. Now, my dear Islam brothers, who will be the poor person on the day of judgment? This was the same question the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam he put towards the Sahaba ikram, the companions. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said to the companions, do you know who will be a poor person on the day of judgment? You might be a haji in this world. You might be a hafiz in this world. You might be an alim in this world. You might be a millionaire in this world. But my dear Islamic brothers, on the day of judgment, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Sahaba ikram said, O Prophet of Allah, is it someone who doesn't have any money, he doesn't have no wealth with him? Is that a poor person? The definition of a poor person in this world, if you ask any person who is a poor person, the definition will be someone who doesn't have money. Someone who hasn't got anything, he is a poor person. But look at the definition the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is given to a poor person. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says, on the day of judgment, a person will come and he will bring forward his salah, his namaz, he will bring forward his fasting, he will bring forward his zakat, and he would have eaten someone's wealth. He would have robbed someone, he would have hit someone. And on that day, a person who he hit someone, on that day, that person will stand up. He will stand up in the court of Allah and he will say, oh Allah, this is the person who slapped me in the world. Ya Allah, I want justice. Imagine, people are crying for justice in this world, in the courts, and they find justice. Do you think that on the day of judgment, when a person, he will be standing in front of Allah, and he will be calling out for justice? What kind of justice will Allah Azza wa Jalla show? My dear Islamic brothers, it is said in the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that that person who hit someone, Allah Azza wa Jalla, he will say to the person he hit, he will say, how many good deeds do you need to go to paradise? And that person, now this person, he could be a haji. He will have mountains of good deeds. He will have millions and billions of good deeds with him. But because he hit someone, that person, he will say, Allah, I need so many good deeds to enter paradise. And Allah, so on that day, he will say, go and take as many good deeds from his account, and then you can go to paradise. Another person will come. So think to yourself, that person you've slapped, that person you looked at and you frightened him, that person you sworn at, that person you hit. My dear Islam brothers, think to yourself. Keep on thinking about all these injustices you have done to them people. Each one of them will stand up and say, Ya Allah, I want justice as well. And he will say, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he will say, by the time people finish, that person will have no good deeds. And then another person will come and he will say, Ya Allah, this is what he did to me in the dunya. This is what he did to me in the world. I want justice as well. And Allah Azza wa Jalla, he will say, whatever deeds you need, go and take it from him. And that person, he will see and there is nothing there. And Allah Azza wa Jalla, he will say to that person, that oppressed person, have you got any sins? And he will say, yeah. And Allah Azza wa Jalla, he will say, give your sins to him. Now sins will be put on his book of deeds. And then that person will be left with no good deeds of mine. He was a millionaire. He was a very, very respected person in the world. People kissed his hands. People respected him. But because of these injustices he has been doing on people, he will have nothing. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says, "Oh my beloved companions, that is a poor person. He is poor. He will have nothing on you on the day of judgment." My dear Islamic brothers, today if we look at our life today, now there might be someone we've sworn at. Because we are part of a gang. Because we are not scared of anyone, because, yeah, I've got my mates, they can cover up for me. If someone tries to even look at me with these dirty eyes, I've got the whole gang with the Lord sat upon you. So you are making people frightened. You are walking on the roads with guns. You are walking on the roads, my dear Islam brothers, you are frightening people. And because of that, never ever think to yourself, you will be a fool if you think to yourself that you are, people are frightened of you. Because people, they respect you. People will come up to you and say, "How are you, brother? How are you doing?" You might think to yourself that they're respecting me. Yeah, man, these people are respecting me. So this is the life we need to adopt. You don't be a fool. They are not respecting you. They are only scared of you. And you are walking on the world. If these people are scared of you, you will have to answer to Allah on the day of judgment. How long are you going to live in this world? Shall I tell you about a story about a young brother who was part of a gang? How long these kind of people will live in this world? All their life, they will live in fear. They will live in fear that they're going to get caught one day, they're going to get bound up in jail for one day, or they might get shot one day. A 19-year-old brother in Bolton. This is about in 2005. We went on a Madni Kafila, and in the masjid was full, and there were loads of people. And there was a funeral there as well. And after the funeral, we asked the brothers there whose funeral it is. And they said that this is the funeral of a 19-year-old lad. He has just been released from jail after serving 4 years. You think to yourself, Wallah, if he's been in jail, where was he before? He was in a young offenders institute at the age of 15. Why? Because he was mixed with the wrong crowd. He mixed in with the wrong people. All his education in school wiped out. All that, everything was wiped out. 19-year-old, he came back from jail. Again, as soon as he came out, because we had that lust, we think that this is power. People are scared of you, that is power. That is not power. What happened? When he was released from jail, they say that about 3 or 4 weeks later, because he was part of another gang, and the other gang, the rival gang, they caught up with him and they shot him. Not only shot him, they shot him in the head. Not only that, they ran him over as well. He was trampled over with the car. And they say that his body was, people couldn't recognize him. And they took him to the hospital. And my dear Islamic brothers, when he died, they took him to the hospital and they did an autopsy on him. What is an autopsy? From the head, from here. They split open his head right to the back of the head. Now you might be thinking, well, he's dead, so he's not going to feel any pain. According to the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, a person, he feels more pain when he dies. He will feel more pain. If you pinch a dead person, he's not going to answer to you. He's not going to say anything to you. He's not going to shout, "Wow, I'm painful." He's not going to say anything. But according to the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he is very, very, very painful. More pain than a person who is alive. Just imagine, when he was, they did an autopsy, so they split open his head from front till the back, and from here right to the belly button. And the brothers who went to do ghusl, they said that the doctors, they came up to us and they said that, you know, try being a bit gentle on him, because if you try to move his body with force, then all his wounds will open, all them, they will open and things will just pop out. That is the end result. Who wants that end result? I don't think anyone does.